My name is Haley Euler.
And I'm Eric Euler.
One of my happiest moments in my life was having Cole. Not too long after he was born and they handed him to me, he looked into my eyes and was holding my finger, and it was pure joy. It's so amazing having a baby, and he was like the most beautiful thing we had ever seen.
He's a crazy little guy, lots of energy. He cares for everyone. He can get along with just about anybody. He loves being outdoors, just seeing the trees, playing in the dirt. Cole was a very chill baby. He just relaxed. He always compromised.
We had a pediatrician mention that he was low tone. He was more of a floppy baby. It meant he is more likely to fall out of our arms.
He didn't like to be held real close. He didn't like a lot of physical contact.
He wasn't crawling in the period of time that he was supposed to be crawling.
His speech just wasn't really coming along. We could tell he wanted to express more.
So we did our first round of genetic testing when he was 2, and the results came back negative. Cole continued to have challenges. And instead of the challenges kind of going away, they started to grow. We would seek answers like, does he have autism? And we would be like, well, he has atypical autism because he's too social. He really wants to engage with others. He wants to play. He wants to be present with them. He has challenges, but that takes him off of the spectrum. We met other parents who had done genetic testing, and they had found a genetic reason for their kid's speech delay. We were given the suggestion to get whole exome sequencing. So then we went back to the geneticist.
She recommended we wait a little bit longer, but we just felt like we knew that there was something. We had to go and search for it.
The month of my son's 5th birthday, I got a call that the geneticist was surprised that she found a cause for his array of challenges. And she identified that it was isolated to one gene, a point mutation on the SETBP1 gene. Have an answer, but there's hardly any cases documented. There was no name for the disorder. There's no community. The geneticist said, here are 2 publications, and we think it's this. Here's your information. Go home. That's it.
We're like, well, what's next? Like, what do we need to be concerned about? Is there other things that can happen that we need to be planning for? How do we help our son the best that we can? There just wasn't a whole lot of information out there.
There were a lot of nights of crying because you feel a bit lost and not knowing how to help your child. After almost a year, I hadn't gotten many answers.
We got involved with a research project called the Tiger Study at the University of Washington.
I asked them what we could do. What have other people in our shoes done? What have they done to help make a difference for their kids? And they mentioned that they knew of a couple of others who had started nonprofits. That year, which was 2017, we formed SETBP1 Society. We currently have 58 families in our group worldwide. Now, when kids get a diagnosis, some of them have been given a picture of my son. They immediately have a community. They have an organization dedicated to helping to spread awareness, helping to find targeted treatments to help their children. Right now, our community has non-targeted treatments. So if you have a speech delay, then you get speech therapy. But our kids take medications for ADHD, some for seizures, some for behavior, some for anxiety, but none of them are targeted to SETBP1. And we do feel that by trying to find a treatment that targets SETBP1, that targets the actual cause, that it will be a more meaningful treatment for our kids. So we think that the science and the technology is here and it's available. We think the potential of finding a targeted treatment is real. All of the funds that are donated go towards research. We want to make a difference in the lives of kids like my son and all kids with SETBP1 disorder. And the only way to do that is by funding research, by going directly to the researchers and giving them what they need to get started on finding affected pathways, finding out what the gene does. And that's where we feel we can make that difference.
Thank you for your support of SETBP1 Society and all children impacted by SETBP1 disorder.
Help us this Giving Tuesday by supporting SETBP1 Society.